questions I get asked all the time about playing guitar is there a way, is there sort of a systematic way to figure out how to play songs by ear? In other words, you have the song in your head. How do you know what chords to put with that song without scouring the internet for crazy chord charts and tabs? Well, it turns out that there is quite a systematic way of going about it, and I'm going to guess right now that it's a lot easier than you think it is, okay? And I'm going to show you by example in this little mini lesson how we use a basic theory called 1-4-5. You might have heard of that before, maybe you haven't, but it doesn't matter for this lesson because I'm just going to use it to figure out how to play a particular song. I'm going to pretend I don't know how to play, just as an example. Okay, so we're going to use three chords. We're going to use the chords G, C, and D. That's it. Okay? Those chords happen to be, if you do have some understanding of 1-4-5, chords number 1, number 4, and number 5 in the key of G. G is number 1, C is number 4, and D is number 5. Now, if these numbers and stuff confuse you or you don't understand them, I'll tell you at the end of this video where you can get a lot more information about this. But let's actually put it to use right now and learn something, okay? So I want to work with a song called, I'm sure you know it, called You Are My Sunshine. And let's say I'm at a campfire or something and I just want to be able to pull this one out of my hat without flipping through some music book. And so I'm going to use the three chords G, C, and D. So here's the process I'm going to go through. I'm going to start on G, and I'm going to play the song and sing it until, and accompany myself very, very simply with a strum, until the G chord sort of doesn't sound right anymore, until it conflicts with my voice. Okay, so here we go. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy. See, right there in happy, it goes a little off for me. So what I'm going to do at that juncture when things start to sound funky is try, by trial and error, one of my other two options. Now remember, my other two options are C or D. You make me, let's try D. Happy. Don't like it so much. Let's try C. You make me happy. Now that sounds really nice in there. So now what I'm going to do, again, just trial and error, I'm going to stay on the C until that doesn't work anymore. And then I'll still have my other two options to see what might work better. So we have, you make me happy when skies are gray. Well, on gray, it goes gray. It doesn't sound good anymore. So I'm on C. What are my other options? G or D? What should I try? I guess I'll try G. You make me happy when skies are gray. Yes. And again, I'm going to stay on the G until it doesn't work anymore. You'll never know. Don't like it on no. I think I'm going to try the C there. No, dear. So I'll go back to G. Love you. Never take my sunshine. And right in there, it starts to sound a little sour. C has been working great. Let's see if it still works there. Don't ever take my sunshine. Not so great. Let's try the D there. Don't ever take my sunshine. Oh, that sounds good. And since we're coming to the end of the song, chances are, in general, that the song ends on the same chord it began on, okay? And that's just a general rule of thumb. Sunshine, and we began on a G away. Let's try. Are my sunshine, my only sunshine. C, make me happy when the skies to G. To C, you'll never know, dear. So there I worked out by ear, by a system of trial and error, basically, how to play the song I wanted to play using just the three chords G, C, and D. Let's see if we can figure out another song using just those same three chords. So I'm going to pick another real common one you might want to pull out spontaneously, Happy Birthday. Okay, again, we're going to start on G. We're going to play the G until it doesn't work anymore. Then we'll try one of the other two options. Happy birthday to you. Right there, I don't like it on the word you. So my options are C or D. Let's try the C. Happy birthday to you. Don't like that. So let's try the D. Happy birthday to you. Let's stay on the D until it no longer works. Happy birthday to you. Right there. Now my instinct tells me to go back to G, though I could try the C. I'll tell you, going back to G. Happy birthday to you. And again, we'll stay on the G till it no longer works. Happy birthday, dear you. Let's try the D. That worked last time. Happy birthday, dear you. Don't like it. Let's try C there. Happy birthday, dear you. Oh, yeah. And from there on out, stay on the C till it doesn't work anymore. Happy birthday. Right there. I'm going to go back to G. Birthday to you. So there we've sketched out the entire song again using just three chords. Now, this is not a coincidence. It turns out that zillions of songs can be worked out this way using just three chords. And in the key of G, those three chords happen to be G, C, and D. But this system works in every single key across the board, and it's that easy once you understand what your options are and what your options are not. So you're not trying every single chord you ever heard of. You're basically trying very, very, very likely candidates. And that is the secret behind 1-4-5 theory or basic chord theory. And so I want you to try, now that we've done two songs together, try in the key of G, using G, C, and D, to work out another couple of sort of basic, simple songs. I'm going to suggest you try Oh Susanna, maybe something like Jingle Bells, just some basic, easy folk songs like that, and see how you do with it. And if you're interested in learning more about it, learning to do it in other keys, learning to do it with more complicated songs, I will point you to some resources below, but go off and have fun with this.